Hello friends, welcome to our channel. In this lecture, I would like to show how to identifying zero force members. What is zero force member? A zero force member is a member in a truss which given specific load is at rest conditions. These zero force members is often found at pins when there is no external load is applied. Okay, you please remember that point. If these zero forces are often found at pins when there is no external load is applied. So friends, following are the thumb rules to identify the zero force members. So go for first point. Single force cannot be exist. So this is a horizontal force or else you take vertical force or any inclined force. Single force cannot be exist in nature. If it exists, it must be considered as zero force. So that is horizontal force, vertical force or any other force. Okay, then go to the second point. So here is the second point. If two forces are acting at a joint, so here joint will be O. The forces will be OA one force, OB another force. If two forces are acting at a joint O and these two forces are acting mutually perpendicular to each other, that is OA force is perpendicular to OB, then these two forces also considered as zero forces. Why means? So go for the description. If I am resolving these forces horizontally, so if I am resolving horizontally means only horizontal forces will be considered. Therefore, force in member OA will be equal to zero. There is no another force here. That is the reason these forces will be considered as zero. Then sigma V equal to zero. If I am resolving this force vertically, there is only one vertical force here. There is no another force acting with some angle to resolve along vertically. That is the reason there is only one vertical force. If I am resolving that one, force in member OB will be equal to zero. Therefore, you please remember this point also. If two forces are acting at a joint and these two forces are mutually perpendicular to each other, then these two forces are also considered as zero forces. Then go to the third point. Friends, see here, this is a third point. If two forces are acting at a joint and these two forces are collinear to each other, means these two forces are acting in the same line, means that is collinear to each other, then these forces must be equal and opposite to each other. So that is force in member OA will be equal to force in member OB. So what is the description for this one means? There is no vertical force to resolve vertically here. If I am resolving this one horizontally, what you will get? Force in member OB minus force in member OA equal to 0. If I am taking, why? Because both are acting away. This one will be right side, this one will be left side. That is the reason I am taking force in member OB minus force in member OA. If I am taking this one minus outside means force in member OA will be equal to force in member OB. So whenever you observe this type of forces, you can take equal and opposite to each other. So you please remember this one also. If two forces are acting at a joint and these two forces are acting in the same line which are collinear to each other, then these forces must be equal and opposite to each other. That is force in member OA will be equal to force in member OB. Then go for the fourth point. See here, this is a fourth point. If three forces are acting at a joint O, two of them are acting in the same line, that is collinear to each other, and the third one is non-collinear to these forces, then the third force must be equal to zero here. So how it will be zero means, you go to the description. If I am resolving these forces horizontally, what happens? Force in member OA, if I am resolving this one horizontally, so theta opposite will be sine theta, adjacent will be cos theta. So therefore, if I am in the horizontal members means you will get cos theta. Force in OA, so this, if I am resolving this one horizontally, you will get here in the same line, force in OA plus force in OC cos theta equal to, this force in OB will be in the opposite direction to these forces. That is the reason taking minus force in OB. So I am sending that minus outside. You will get force in OA plus force in member OC into cos theta equal to force in member OB. Okay, then go to the next step. You resolve this one vertically, sigma V equal to 0. So horizontal forces cannot be resolved vertically here, but here which is acting some angle, I am resolving this one vertically. Force in member OC into how much it will be? Theta opposite sine theta, which is vertical. Force in member OC sine theta will be equal to 0. Again, I am sending the sin theta this side. You will get force in member OC will be equal to 0. Sin theta into 0 equal to 0. Therefore, force in member OC equal to 0. After obtaining force in member OC equal to 0, I am substituting here. You will get force in member OA will be equal to force in member OB. Friends, what I am selling means, if three members are acting at a joint, two of them are collinear to each other, and whatever the non-collinear force will be considered as a zero force. So you please take down this one. This non-collinear member will be considered as zero force. Therefore, force in member will be OC will be equal to zero. After obtaining this, after considering this force in member OC will be equal to zero means, then this force will be mutually opposite to each other. So like third point. See here, after considering the third force in member OC 0, then here it will be obtaining this condition. Therefore, force in member OA will be equal to force in member OB. You please remember that point also. Then go to the next step, that is fifth point. If three forces are acting at a particular joint, that is O, two of them are collinear to each other. That is force in member OA equal to force in collinear. Force in member OA and OB are collinear to each other. And the third force is not collinear. That is acting perpendicular to these forces. Then the third force must be considered as zero here. So how you will get that one zero means? You go to the description. If I am resolving this one vertically, so there is no another forces here to resolve the vertically. That is the reason you will get directly force in member OC will be equal to 0. Then automatically what happens? This is similar to the third case. Force in member OA will be equal to force in member OB. So after considering this force in member OC will be equal to 0, then automatically this force in member OA will be equal to force in member OB. Or else you can resolve this one sigma h equal to 0, take down force in member OA minus force in member OB, then that one will be take down negative outside, therefore force in member OA will be equal to force in member OB. So this is very simple, friends. You please remember these are the some point. Means these are some thumb rules for identifying zero force members. This is very, very simple. I hope you understand my lecture. If you like this video, please like this video and share it to your friends and subscribe my channel. Thank you so much for watching my video.